Hi ho, it's Silver with this week's happiness hack, which is number 5 of 5 in our series on self-care that we've been doing this month. And I'm pretty excited about this one because it's one that's new to me. In other words, it's something I'm experimenting with that I hadn't done before. And it's been pretty interesting, I have to tell you. So this week's happiness hack is gift yourself with a grown-up timeout. Don't you love people who do those air quotes, but giving yourself a timeout is just an incredible thing. And I've been doing this now for the last couple of months since I read this article that said that if in fact you give yourself one day a week completely off, then what you end up with is 7.5 weeks of vacation, which who wouldn't want 7.5 weeks of vacation? But here's the rub. It's a day where you don't do anything productive. So I don't clean closets, I don't do errands, I don't do ironing. I pretty much just do whatever I want that is non-productive. And it's been really interesting for me because I've gotten very clear that I spent a lot of time working and doing busy work in order to not face feelings. And I thought it would be horrible, and it's not been at all. It's been really a gift. So you can do something productive if it's something that you really love to do. Like this woman loves to bake, but she never gives herself time to just do that because she's busy doing all those other important things in her life. So this is a day, her day of doing nothing is a day of baking because it brings her such great joy. So gift yourself with a grown-up timeout and, you know, be creative about it. I have tried to figure out some things that I want to do. First of all, I don't know about you, but I love to read, and I don't read nearly as much as I'd like to, so I've been reading a lot on my day off. And I do, you know, basically if I went on a real vacation where I went to, say, Hawaii or out on the country or something, you know, I wouldn't be ironing, I wouldn't be cleaning out drawers, I wouldn't be checking my emails all the time. I would be doing vacation things. And so this is sort of a staycation for me once a week, but it really works out nicely. And I gotta tell you, the benefit is that, first of all, I'm more productive during the week. Part of the reason for that is because I know I have one less day to catch up. And I don't know about you, but I spent a lot of time in my life figuring, oh, well, I can always catch up over the weekend. And so I end up working 7 days a week, which is not a good thing. Does this sound familiar to any of you? So I actually get more done during the week, and I'm more relaxed during the week because I feel like I've had a break from it all. My brain has had a break, which it desperately needs. And so I want you to experiment with this. I'd love to hear from you how that's working for you. If a day seems a little extreme, like you're beginning to get nervous about it, start with 3 or 4 hours. Just take, start even with 2 if that's the best you can do. 2 hours of completely not doing anything productive, and then just add a little time each week until you get to the full 24 hours. But it is so worth it. And you know, if you also take a real vacation, you know, that you go away somewhere, you end up having like 9.5 weeks of vacation, and now you can pretend you're a European because the Europeans know how to go on vacation, I gotta tell you. So I hope this is useful to you. Next month, what we're going to talk about is self-talk and how to use that to make yourself happier than you are now. And I want you to know that you deserve to be happy, and it is possible. So until we meet again, bye for now.